Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. And in my this particular video, I am going to show you the SVM or support vector machine modeling using different kernels. Okay, in this particular video, I am going to discuss with polynomial kernel. In my upcoming video, I am going to show you with Gaussian kernel. Okay, so I am taking the same data set which I have taken earlier also for showing you this simple fit CSVM model in MATLAB. And if you go to the documentation, if you just search kernel function here, let me write kernel function. Okay. Yes. See here in the kernel function, what you will be getting that here polynomial one, if you observe, it is not default. Default one is linear. Okay. When our data set has two classes, for two class learning, linear is the default one. And if you check our data set, purchased and not purchased, only two different values present, two different class. So by default, it is going to be linear. So whatever I have shown in my previous video, that is basically linear. Now we are going to change that to polynomial and we are going to visualize that. Okay. So the code is quite simple. CLC clear all, close all, warning off. And here, what I am going to do, instead of importing from import data from the home, what I am doing, I am using read table function, which is widely used in MATLAB for reading one data set. Okay, like in Python using pandas, we do read CSV, right? Similarly here, read table. Okay, as simple as that. We are reading the table, so read table. Okay, then we are basically doing feature scaling for age and our income, okay, estimated salary, okay. And then what I am doing, this is our visualization part. Point to be noted, this classification model fit CSVM data comma purchased, that is purchased is dependent on age and estimated salary. I am giving nothing, means by default it is going to take linear, okay. All right, I will show you the kernel function also, and then I am doing the visualization. So this is nothing but previously whatever I have shown, SVM classification visualization using linear kernel. Okay, then another figure window, I am taking another classification model, and this time I am giving some piece of argument. One is kernel function, which is going to be polynomial. Okay, I am changing my kernel to polynomial, and polynomial order. Okay, by default polynomial order, what you know, 3. Here it is written in MATLAB documentation. Let me suppose first take 2. Okay, then what we are going to do, then I am basically copying and pasting the same visualization code whatever we have taken earlier also, okay. And the title is SVM visualization using polynomial kernel. Okay, Control A and evaluate selection. If I just run this particular part of the code, it will take some time, and see how beautifully it is giving the visualization output. This red one is not purchased, green one is purchased. Here this red one is not purchased and green one is purchased. You can clearly understand that here decision boundary is going to be linear because our kernel function is linear by default one. Okay, but here as we are taking polynomial, okay, of order 2, so here basically we are getting one curved set in the decision boundary part. Okay, so here instead of writing like this, here let me just copy this polynomial. If you think that what is the default one you want to check, so what you can do in the first function, instead of kernel function, here you can add one extra parameter, kernel function linear. Then also you will be getting same, because linear is the default one. So there is no meaning that if you want to make linear decision boundary, then you need no need to specify kernel function as linear, because you are going to get the same. Okay, but what will happen if you increase the polynomial order, like obviously up to a certain level, it will the accuracy will increase, then it will decrease due to overfitting, right? I can make higher order polynomial like maybe 5, and then what will happen, our decision boundary will be more kind of change, there will be rapid change, and the boundary will try to fit on data set in a more accurate fashion. Okay, like here I can show you, this is our linear one, and this is now polynomial kernel with degree 5, and as you can see here that it is trying to overfit in our data set. Okay, so be very careful with the value of polynomial order for while using polynomial kernel, right?